Now, there is a small question, a small problem. Can we have a private member function within a class? As we have seen, member function must be defined publicly within a class, because every time they are need to be called from outside a class or from a main function. So there is a question, can we have a private member function? If I say no, so it will be a wrong. Yes, you can have a private member function within a class. As in the given example, again the same class student, roll number and name, show data, this time is defined privately within a class. In public, I've defined a get data where input and output, input is there. Void main, I'm calling s.getData after declaring an object. If I call s.showData, so for this statement, again compiler will give an error, not accessible. The reason behind, at this time showData is not publicly defined, is defined privately within a class. The question is this, how we can define, how we can call it? Always remember, private member functions of a class is always can be defined from a public member function of a class. What would be the hierarchy in this case? Again, the program will start from the main. Object is declared. I'm calling a function getData, s.getData, control will get jumped. In case void get data, roll number and name, user will input, and from the get data there is another call show data, and you can say here it is call for a private member function. So in this way you can invoke private member function of a class. After this, we'll discuss passing an object to a function. Passing a function, objects to a function. What does that mean? I'll not give you the exact program in C by using class, sorry, in C++ by using classes. Let me write one small program by using structure, and we'll switch from that program which is defined, which we will define by using structure, to the classes. And let's have a complete difference between structure and classes, how the objects can be passed to a function. If I define a structure, point, having two elements, int x, int y, close the structure. The idea behind this, I'll declare over here three variable of structure point p1, p2, p3. There will be three different memories for its element, so called x and y will be allotted. One for p1, another for p2, another for p3. Because the number of objects are declared, the number of memories allocated for its elements, and in case of classes, number of objects you declared, number of memories allocated for its data members. We'll take an input from p1 object, or by p1 object, we'll take an input by p2 object. Let's say user input 5 and 6 for p1. Let's say user input 4 or 5 by p2. We need to sum of both of them and we'll store it in p3. 5 plus 4, 9. 6 plus 5, 11. and how the thing can be implemented in structure and how we can implement in classes. Let's have a look. I'll define the functions, all of these three variables, not globally, by declaring them within a main function as a local object or local structure variable. Void getXY, I'm talking about passing an object to a function. So in case of structure, I'll pass a dir structure to a function. So I need to declare a variable as a formal parameter in order to accept that structure variable, which will be, which I'll pass from the main. Here I'll use a little bit concept of C++ also, like a reference variable. You must be aware with the concept of reference variable. In this case, I'll sum both of them over here, p1 dot x, not p1, p3 dot x is equals to p1 dot x plus p2 dot x, p3y dot and I'll go for the output over here. Let me define the void main function for this thing. There will be three structure variables which I am going to declare it locally within a class, within a main function. I'll call all of these functions one by one. How I'll call it? First of all, I'll call get function getXY, passing in structure variable p1 as a parameter. But as we know, this is an actual parameter, it's a formal parameter. And in case of whenever we pass a value to a function, there is a separate memory for the actual and formal parameter. Doesn't matter the name is same or different. It can be same or it can be different, but the memory is always different. So in case I'm calling a function getXY by passing a structure variable p1, which will assign or initialized over here, if I input any value over here, will not be reflected back to the p1 because this is a concept of call by value. In order, if I want, I'm inputting a value in p.x and p.y, which should reflect back to the p1 structure variable, which is declared within a main. So it should be implemented call by reference. Call by reference can be implemented by in two different ways, by using a pointer variable, which we can implement in case of C, or by using a reference variable which is not in C. So here, instead of star, instead of by using pointer concept, I'll use the concept of reference variable which is in C++. Reference variable which is not having any on memory, which always refer to the another object or a variable by which it is initialized. So in this case, the reference of p1 will get assigned in p, p.x, p.y, whatever you input the value will reflect back to the structure variable p1. And then in the same way, I'm calling another, the same function with another structure variable p2. And now this p, this time for the second call, will hold the reference of p2. Whatever I input will reflect to the value of p2. Now I'm having a value in p1 and p2 both. P1 P1 dot x, P1 dot y, P2 dot x, P2 dot y, some xy. Some xy, I required 3 arguments. So I'll pass from here P1, P2 and P3. Right now, P1 is having a value which is reflected. P2 is having a value which is reflected from the getXY function. P3 is an empty right now. So I want the final result should be stored in P3, which again I'll pass as a call by reference, as a reference variable. So no separate memory will be allotted for P3 right now. So now here the things have implemented P1 dot x, P2 dot y, P1 dot y, P2 dot y. The sum of both of them will get stored in P3 dot x and P3 dot y. Let's take a dummy example. Get x y by using a P1 user input 5 and 6. By using P2, user has entered 4 and 5. Now, if I'm calling a function sum x y, P1 is having a 5 and 6, P2 is having a 4 and 5, P3 is having nothing. Capital P1 and capital P2 will get assigned to small P1 and small P2, and the same way capital P3 will assign to P3, the reference of capital P3 will be here. Small P1 dot x, small P2 dot x will be having at this time 5 and 4. 5 plus 4 will become 9, which will be stored in P3 dot x, which automatically will reflect the capital P3 structure variable, which is declared in the main. P1 dot y, P2 dot y, this time is having 6 and 5. Which becomes 11, it will reflect through small p3 to capital p3. By calling a function show xy, if you pass p1, p2, P3. You will be having an output over here, P dot x, P dot y. The first call, the value of capital P1 will get assigned to P. You will be having an output 5 and 6. And the same, the value of P2 will get assigned to P. You will be having an output 4 and 5. And the final resultant, capital P3 is assigned to this P, and you will be having the final value, that is 9 and 11. In this way, what we have done, we have passed a structure variable to a function. I must say, you try it once to convert it, this example, into a classes, and then check this, how it can be defined from here.